Welcome back to Smartpreneur Academy for Simply Reliable, where we're talking about Design Machine. In video number three, we're going to discuss the product library. Now, Design Machine comes with a starter library that you can manipulate, change, add to, delete, etc. And the way you manage that library is to launch Design Machine and go to Manage Products. Under Manage Products, you'll see a certain number of brands over here, and you can look by make or you can look by category. If you open one of those makes up, for instance, a speaker, you'll see the speakers that are there that are in the library. When you click on the device itself, you'll see if there's inputs and there's outputs to that device. Now, if you want to create a new product, so let's say we don't have one of these in there, there's a couple different ways you can do that. We can just start from scratch. So we can click on New Product and pick a name. And maybe this happens to be a receiver. So let's say it's an Integra. I'm going to use a fake model number on this just to show you how to do it. So let's call it an SR50. And I might want to give it a category. There's a list of categories in here. That just helps me kind of find it if I'm searching for it. So I'll put it as a receiver. You may or may not want a description. This just helps you, again, identify what this is. So maybe it's a surround receiver with Atmos. You'll see there's a section here for driver. Under the control integration section for control 4, if you've located the driver, or if the driver comes along with it, you'll see the driver name and information in here as well. If not, then it'll be blank. All right, so let's hit save on that. Now that has created our device down here. And now we want to give it some inputs, we want to give it some outputs. So we can do that by clicking add input, add output, or add sequence. So let's add an input first. I'll click add input, double click on it, or you can right click, and maybe I'm going to put power in. So I'll give the name of it as power, and the type of power is it's AC power. And I save that and I'm done. Let's give it an output. So I'll click add output. In this case, I'll right click and I'll edit. And this might be front speakers. And the type of signal in this case would be a speaker signal. The signal type we'll talk about a little bit later. Very, very important. This is what allows you to connect one device to another. So that's how you create an input and how you create an output. This is a really neat feature called Add Sequence. If I click on that, I can choose either an input or an output. So I'll choose input in this case. And maybe these are going to be video inputs. That's what they're labeled. And their signal type might be HDMI. So I type in an H, I see HDBHTs pop up, HDMI is here, I'm gonna hit enter. That's gonna choose that signal type. And now the question is, how many of them are there? Maybe there's four. So I'll hit save, and boom, it automatically creates those for us. You can also duplicate. So if I come over to front speakers and I duplicate that, then maybe I want to just change this to rear, and boom, you can create things very, very quickly. Once that's all set, you click save, and it's now part of your library. You can also duplicate an entire product. Let's say, for example, I've got a Blu-ray player right here, this DBS 50.3. Let's say the new model comes out, it's called a 50.5. I can simply click on that and right click and click duplicate. And then I'm going to edit it. And I'll get rid of the word copy. And I'll change this to 5. And most likely the inputs and outputs are pretty much the same. But if you need to add additional inputs or outputs, you can modify that at the time. And then just click save and you're all set. Over time, there'll be new releases of Design Machine. And generally as you log in, it will ask you if you want to check for a new update or tell you that there is a new update. But if you ever want to just go check, You can always go up to help and click on check for updates, and it'll go out there and check for a newer version. And in this case, it tells me that I've got the latest version, so there's no need to update. If there's a new one, it'll give you the opportunity to then update. Let's talk for a minute about making sure that your library in Design Machine matches your library in SmartOffice online if you're using both of them together. They are currently two separate libraries. So what's very, very important is that the model numbers and the names, the way they're written here, are the same as they would be in SmartOffice. So for instance, in SmartOffice, I have a manufacturer control 4, I have a model number C4-wall(10-1)BL. In Design Machine, I want to make sure, if I'm building this product from scratch, that the make and the model number are exactly the same. Now, in another video, we're going to talk about importing proposals from SmartOffice into Design Machine, so we'll show how to do that there. But that's the best way to make sure that the products in SmartOffice and the products in Design Machine are exactly the same. In another video, we'll discuss how to import your proposal from SmartOffice into Design Machine, and of course that will bring with it the make and the model number. If it's already in there, of course, that's why you want to make sure they're the same so that they match up. Earlier in the video, I mentioned signal types. Here's an example of a bunch of signal types that are in our system. Input and output, you'll see a choice of signal type, and these are the items that you can choose from. You want to be very careful not to get too specific, but specific enough so that like items can get connected to each other, because they have to have matching signal types in order to connect. If you find there's a signal type that we haven't covered for some reason, you can create your own signal types. However, be aware that once you've created a signal type, you cannot delete the signal type. We protect you from deleting that because it may be used on a drawing somewhere, and if you wipe it out, it potentially could be gone. So the way you create your own is you're going to go to File and then System Preferences. And we're going to talk more about the System Preferences settings in our next video, video number 4. But while we're on the product library, this pertains to that as well. So you'll select signal types. And admittedly, there's a very small plus button down here. You click the plus button, and then we'll give it a name. I'll just call this new connection, so I have something there. And then from here, you can pick the color. Maybe I want it to be dark red, and I want the style to be a small dash. This has to do with how it's going to look on the drawing. And then the wire color would be the color of the actual wire itself. The type of wire that it might be, and if there's any specific patch cable that might be part of, for instance. You can also assign it a system, audio, communications, control, electrical, etc. So I'll put this in audio, and then I would hit save. And that's how you create a signal type. You may want to import new manufacturers and export manufacturers. For instance, you might have multiple Design Machines in your company, and you might want to share these files with other people. Maybe you've done some work creating inputs and outputs. So under File, you'll see Import, and with Import, I can import a Design Machine product file that someone else has exported out, or I can click Download Design Machine Products. All right, so on the product import, we're going to select a manufacturer. And let's say we choose Amex as an example. And you've got a choice you can make here. You can choose to overwrite the connections on existing matching products. If you want that to happen, then you would check this box. What that means is maybe you've done some work on some Amex products and you don't want to overwrite those connections, then you would leave that unchecked. And then Design Machine will just bring in the other products and the other inputs and outputs. But if you've not done any work at all, then you may want the latest thing that's in there and go ahead and let it overwrite. So I might check that box, for instance, and then click Download. And Design Machine will grab that product from up in the cloud and then put it into your library. To export and manufacture, we'll go to File and we'll click Export. It'll show you a list of all the manufacturers that you have in your database. And if I select all here, it'll turn them all off. And selecting again, we'll toggle them all on. So let's say I just want to export out maybe my Crestron library. So I can click on Crestron and then click Export. And it's going to find a place to do that. It's going to give you a chance to name it, because you might want to have a different name on this for some reason, so you can. And we'll click Save. All right, so now that's been exported out. Going back to the imports again, this would be an example of maybe you have multiple people working on multiple design machines and they want to exchange the work that they've done on inputs and outputs. So if I were to import that Crestron file into a new design machine, I would come to Import. And this time we're going to choose Import a Design Machine Product File. And I think I put it on the desktop. So there it is. I just choose that product and then click Open. And it loads it into my design machine. And that's the product library. If you have any other questions, feel free to go to help and either live chat or call us. We're always happy to help. Our customer success folks are there to help you out. Stay tuned for video number 4, where we'll talk about system preferences.